Welcome friends for the September edition of Monthly Fixed Income Outlook. We have our fund manager Mr. Kostub who has joined for this session. Welcome Kostub.
Hello Nen.
Kostub, just to continue from the last session we left in terms of RBI rate cut. I think from that rate cut the yields have hardened a bit to the levels of 6.5 now and the growth numbers now at 5%. How do we see this panning out in terms of fixed income ahead?
GDP number came at 5% and they were lower than market consensus and significantly lower than the policymaker estimates. Beyond headline numbers, even the internal looks quite worrisome and weaker in nature. The bigger shocker in this number was a nominal GDP growth of 8%, and this is the lowest number in this series. Weakness in nominal GDP numbers is likely to have impact on overall tax collection, corporate profitability, sustainability of debt, and might look the credit stress even more uglier. On top of it, even the incremental high-frequency indicators indicate that slowdown is still persisting and may be take much longer before the economy starts recovering for now. To sum up, GDP for FY20, we expect it to be around 6% as against RBI expectation of 6.9%. Inflation for July came at 3.15% and it was largely in line with the market estimates and RBI projections. We expect inflation to inch up from here and likely to be in the range of 3.5 to 3.75%. Thus, to sum up, given that the growth is lower by about 90 to 100 basis points from RBI projection and inflation is in line with RBI expectations, there is ample room for RBI to ease by another 50 to 75 basis points over next 6 to 9 months.
Well, Kostub, that seems there is a lot of concern in terms of growth aspects.
Yes.
So as of now till date calendar year, we have seen RBI has cut down almost 110 basis points of repo rate, right?
Yes.
Out of which we hear only the 40 basis points seems to have been transmitted to the investors.
Yes.
The recent news or the measures by RBI linking the bank rates to the external benchmarks like
yes.
repos, do you think this should help faster transmission?
Of course it will help at margin. But the bigger thing is the new proposed liquidity framework, which is about to come over next 30 days. We expect that in order to have a proper monetary policy transmission, RBI will come out with a new liquidity framework. They will clearly state that the framework in line with their stance that the RBI is in. As we know, currently RBI is in accommodative stance. So most likely, the new liquidity framework will be in line with this stance and enough liquidity will be assured to the market so as to make sure that the transmission happens seamlessly.
Well, Kostub, with that background, just to continue further, what is the views in terms of fixed income space ahead?
Being constructive both on duration and liquidity framework, we think for on a risk-adjusted basis, shorter end of the curve looks quite lucrative. Thus, we suggest investors to increase duration in Aditya Birla Sun Life corporate bond funds and banking PSU funds, which invest predominantly in these space. For our risk-averse investors, we would suggest them to move from liquid to various liquid plus funds like ultra short-term fund, low duration funds, and floater funds. In current scenarios, of course, floater funds makes lot of sense.
Kostub, you mentioned about the floater strategy.
Yes.
This sounds a little interesting. Would you like to elaborate more in terms of for our investor to understand this strategy better?
Sure. In the current scenario, we think the floating rate funds, they are the best place liquid plus funds. So in these funds, we buy 1 to 2 year corporate bond fund, which are predominantly AAA PSU corporate bonds and pay OIS against this for the similar tenure. Thus, essentially, we are locking a spread between the OIS and corporate bonds for the similar maturities. Currently, as against the historical spread of 120 basis points, the bond swap spread in today's scenario is at 190 basis points. So clearly, there is 70 basis point extra spread which market is currently willing to pay. As the new liquidity framework ticks in, we expect that this spread should at least revert to its median levels, which is at 120 basis points. We have been quite agile in managing this as a strategy and it has performed quite well over last many years. Further, 100% of the fund is invested in AAA category papers, which are predominantly PSU entities. On top of it, the YTM of the fund is about 80 to 120 basis point over the normal liquid fund on account of steep term premium which market pays in 1 to 3 year corporate bonds. Thus, on a risk-adjusted basis, For the investors who have an investment horizon of 3 to 6 months, we think this is one of the best liquid plus fund strategy available now.
Kaustubh, I think this sounds interesting, and I'm sure our viewers will also look forward for this strategy keenly. Thank you, Kaustubh, for your time and insights. I hope viewers enjoyed the outlook. Please keep watching more for further updates in coming sessions.
Thank you, investors.
Thanks, Kaustubh. Thank you, viewers.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.